What's up, guys? Olaleko is my name. This is a practical morphometric analysis, a step-by-step approach to 2D and 3D models. Morphometric has a wide area of applications, both in craniofacial, fish morphology, leaf morphology, fish analysis, orthodontics analysis, and geometry, and many more. It could be applied in science, in engineering, in medicine, and social science. Here, we'll be covering many areas, because many people have taught morphometrics, but they take only portion of the subject area and they presented it. But here in this teaching, we want to teach morphometrics step by step by content and step by step practically. Who really need this? Who really need morphometrics? Are you a scientist or biologist dealing with statistical shape or image analysis? Are you researchers in the field of forensics studies of human facial morphology, such as face recognition, age estimation, set dimorphism, and facial expression recognition? Are you a student and researchers in evolutionary anthropology and cognitive science? Are you a student or researchers in hypothesizing on quantitative genetics and general purpose species in identification, such as in plants, in animals, and in human? Are you expert conducting research on disease diagnosis or in genetic disorder prediction? Are you a student and researchers in orthodontics, phylogenetics, biomechanics, bioinformatics, neuroimage analysis, and bone histomorphometry? Are you a student and researchers in geomorphometrics or terrain analysis? This is for you. So let me quickly give us the content of what we are going to cover under this subject. We're going to cover the introduction, which is the concept of morphometrics, looking at definitions and two types of morphometrics we have, the traditional and geometric. We're going to look at landmarks and acquisitions, which is definitions of landmarks, type of landmarks, landmark homology, landmark acquisition and tools, error assessment, and proquest ANOVA. We're going to look at visualization issues, how to visualize our landmarks using general proquest ANOVA analysis, visualization tools such as principal component analysis. We have to look at thin plate spline, deformation grids, and lollipop graphs. We want to perform some static analysis on our landmark data, such as ANOVA, MANOVA, ANOSIM, PAMANOVA, regression, discriminant analysis, canonical variant analysis, HEDMA, clustering. We're going to discuss some sample size issues, and further reading and research paper will be presented unto us. So let's quickly look at the introduction of morphometrics. Let me introduce to the subject by definitions and by types. What is morphometrics? Morphometrics comes from two Greek words, morphe, which means shape or form, and metria, which means measurement. This means morphometrics is the measurement of shape or form, which means anything that has shape or form can be measured. Here, we turn shape or form into numbers, and we test the numbers using different testing methods or testing tools. That is what we do in morphometrics. If you look at this particular shape by my right ear, it has a graph here, and in this graph we have a shape on it. This shape is a fish-like shape, and it has numbers surrounds it. So this shape has been turned into numbers, and the number will be tested using different testing tools. Then we are going to analyze on the numbers, then make some prediction on the numbers after testing. So you can also say it is used for evaluating biological shape variation and correlation of shape with other variables. Also, morphometrics can also be defined as any quantitative measurement and analysis of morphological traits. Okay, we have two types of morphometrics. We have traditional morphometrics, and this involves summarizing morphology in terms of length, measurement, ratio, or angles that can be investigated individually, univariate for one, or several at a time, bivariate for two, and multivariate for many, more than two. So what we do here, we measure length, ratio, and angle in this traditional method. When you look at this fish here, we see a line drawn from this rod down to the tail of the fish, and which measures the length of the fish. And we also see another line drawn from the fin down to this place, which measures the breadth of the fish. So this is the measurement method, and here we are measuring the length and the width. So here we can also measure the ratio of the length and the width that we have measured, and angle can be measured as well. So this is called traditional morphometrics, though it has some drawbacks. it has some limitations. And one of them is that the original shape cannot be reconstructed from the measured indicators. And this is one of the limitations of traditional morphometrics. Also, information about the original shape is lost, which means it cannot be retrieved again. So because of these drawbacks, we now have another advanced method, which is called geometric morphometrics. Geometric morphometrics is the quantitative representation and analysis of morphological shape using geometric coordinates instead of measurement we saw previously. And it has two types as well. It has outline based or landmark based. So this could be outline based, it could be landmark based. And the outline based involves summarizing the shape of open or closed curves, which is called perimeter, typically without fixed landmarks. And landmark based involves summarizing shape in terms of landmark configuration. When you look at my right hand here, you see two fishes here. The first one has some outlines around it in blue color, and this shows that this outline giving this fish a shape, which is outline method. And here we also have the landmark point that are landmarked by expert, which is called anatomical point on the specimen. These points could be many, could be more than this, and they are very, very meaningful because they can be data interpreted individually. So these points are called landmarks points. So this is called landmark method or landmark base. So this is two type of morphometric we have generally, and this is just introduction to morphometrics. In the next video, I will be discussing on landmarks and acquisitions of landmarks before we go into the practical aspect of it. And I want to thank you so much for watching this. If you have watched this video, you can subscribe to see the rest of the videos as we'll be covering the content in details. And you can share, you can like. Thank you so much. I will see you in the next video.